Hello friends, this is Professor Rahul Bhavne, and in the subject of heat transfer, today we will see LMTD method for counter flow heat exchanger. So in previous video, we check out for the parallel flow heat exchanger, now LMTD method for counter flow heat exchanger. So let's start today's video. So counter flow heat exchanger, so basically the difference in parallel and counter flow is the direction of flow, cold fluid and hot fluid. Now for this schematic, we shown that hot fluid is moving from left to right, and the cold fluid when enter from right and it moves parallel to hot fluid but in opposite direction toward left. So in this particular heat exchanger surface area where heat is exchanged from hot fluid to cold fluid, in this particular area both the fluid are parallel but in opposite direction. This is called as a counter flow heat exchanger. Okay, so this is a schematic, hot fluid entering. So we noted at TH1, hot fluid entry 1, hot fluid exit TH2. Similarly for cold fluid, so TC1 is the inlet and TC2 is the outlet. Now the basic phenomena, hot fluid enter at higher temperature, during its pass through the heat exchanger it deliver heat to surrounding cold fluid, so its temperature get decrease, and cold fluid entering at lowest temperature and then it will pass through the heat exchanger and gain the heat from hot fluid and become a warmer and it move out. Now in this complete heat exchanger, highest temperature will be the hot fluid entry temperature and lowest temperature will be the cold fluid entry temperature. Okay, now if we draw for temperature versus area, this is surface area or it is also called as a length of heat exchanger. So temperature versus length or area, so this graph will be there. In this graph there is a little mistake is there, this TC2 level should be here, by mistaken it is copied up to this level. So TC2 is up to this. So in this graph, TH1, hot fluid temperature enter, so highest temperature, move towards outlet, and as a TH2 it will move out from heat exchanger. But cold fluid enter from the second end, TC1, move in opposite direction to hot fluid, gain heat, rise its temperature, and it move out from the heat exchanger as a TC2. So TC2 point is here. So delta T1 will be TH1 minus TC2. Delta T2 will be TH2 minus TC1. Now here we consider a small elementary area for our derivation. Why it is required? Because many times it is asked in a practical or oral exam. Why we consider an elementary section? Because the heat exchange from entry to exit, it is not a constant. If it is a constant, then there is no need of this considering elementary area. There are different ways to calculate that. But heat exchange from hot fluid to cold fluid, that means rate of heat transfer is not constant throughout the heat exchanger. So throughout the heat exchanger, that rate of heat transfer is variable. So such condition, we have to first derive mathematical expression for some elementary section, and then we integrate from inlet condition to outlet condition so that we get the expression for whole heat exchanger. Okay, and as I said in a previous video also, entry of heat exchanger or inlet of heat exchanger will be the that side of heat exchanger where hot fluid enters. and exit of heat exchanger will be the that side where hot fluid exit. Now in this elementary area, suppose this TH is the temperature of hot fluid entering to this elementary section. TH1 is the hot fluid temperature entering to heat exchanger, but TH is the hot fluid temperature entering to elementary area. When it enter to elementary area, so during its pass through this elementary area, it will deliver heat to the cold fluid. Cold fluid entering in opposite direction as a temperature TC, and when it pass through this elementary, so whatever be the heat lost by hot fluid, it will gain the heat and its temperature will rise. So hot fluid in this particular elementary area decreases its temperature by dTH. Cold fluid in this particular elementary area, it rise its temperature by dTC. But as I said, direction of heat exchanger is from inlet of hot fluid to exit of hot fluid. So length of heat exchanger is along this, along x-axis. So along x-axis, if you found, so there is a temperature drop. TH at entry is higher, TH at exit of this elementary area is lower. So along the length of heat exchanger, it is decreasing. So we put minus sign because there is a loss of heat. But for the heat, cold fluid also along the length of heat exchanger. So length will be in this direction, x direction. So along the length, first point come here. So this is the highest point for cold fluid temperature. Along the length, this is the lowest point of cold fluid temperature. So along the length of heat exchanger, we observe that there is again drop of cold fluid temperature. So counter flow heat exchanger, we consider negative sign for cold fluid temperature. Even though in actual cold fluid temperature gain heat, its temperature rise, but along the length, its temperature showing decrease. So we put a negative sign for cold fluid temperature also. Now CH is the heat capacity. CP is always we use many time, and that is a specific heat. But when specific heat is multiplied by mass flow rate, so the product is known as heat capacity. So heat capacity of hot fluid, CC is the heat capacity of cold fluid. Now this is our schematic. So heat exchange across the elementary area. So right now we are focusing on only this elementary area. When we get a mathematical expression, complete mathematical expression for elementary area, then we will shift over to full heat exchanger by integrating that. So for elementary area, heat exchange across the elementary area is dQ, small amount dQ. And this dQ must be heat loss by hot fluid, and it is equals to the heat gain by cold fluid. So again, I am repeating, I am not saying delta TH is equal to delta TC. Temperature drop of hot fluid is equals to temperature rise of cold fluid. I am not saying that. I am only saying heat loss by hot fluid is equals to heat gain by cold fluid. Temperature difference or temperature change is depends on mass flow rate and other property also. So heat loss by hot fluid is equals to heat gain by cold fluid. Heat loss by hot fluid minus sign, MH, CPH of and DTH, change in hot fluid temperature for elementary, is must be equal to minus MC, cold fluid. Why minus? Because along length, we observe that along the length of heat exchanger, here temperature is higher, then along length, the temperature decreases. So minus mass flow rate of cold fluid, CP of cold fluid, DTC, change in temperature of cold fluid. Now both hot and cold fluid temperature decreases with the length of heat exchanger. Hence, here we put the minus sign for both. Now separate this. So dq must be equal to product of this is ch hot fluid heat capacity, cc is cold fluid heat capacity. Now we have this mathematical expression, so we will separate it out now. So dth will be minus dq upon ch. So this minus ch we are shifting on left hand side, so it become minus dq upon ch. Similarly for dtc is equals to minus dq upon cc. Now taking a difference of these two, so dth minus dtc is equals to dq 1 upon ch minus 1 upon cc. Minus sign we take out as a common, so we get this relation. Now here dth minus dtc is the change in hot fluid temperature, change in cold fluid temperature, and dq is that small amount of heat exchange between hot fluid to cold fluid. So for dq, overall heat transfer coefficient u, small amount for area, so dA, and temperature difference for elementary will be th minus tc. And this dth minus dtc we rewrite as a difference of hot fluid and cold fluid temperature. Remember, again I am repeating, this is not a taking a d common. Taking a d common, so th minus tc, that is not the case. Here we actually taking a difference of hot fluid minus cold fluid is equals to u dA. Th minus tc, again hot fluid minus cold fluid temperature, in bracket 1 upon ch minus 1 upon cc. Now putting a different notations, 1 minute. Hello. Sorry, there was one call. Okay. So we put for simplicity delta T, D of delta T is equals to minus U dA delta T and this bracket. Now we shifting this delta T on left hand side. So 1 upon delta T into D of delta T is equals to minus U dA 1 upon CH minus 1 upon CC. Now this is our final expression for elementary area. So we will integrate this elementary area mathematical expression within a limit from inlet to exit. So from 1 to 2, then it will become a expression for whole heat exchanger. So this is our equation, final equation. Now integrate from 1 to 2. So integration 1 to 2, 1 upon delta T upon D of delta T is equals to minus U. This whole bracket is a constant. Integration of 1 to 2 of dA. If I integrate this small elementary area from inlet to exit, then it will be the total area of heat exchanger. So this integration will be the capital A, total area of heat exchanger. Now here on left hand side, so it become ln of delta T2 minus ln of delta T1. After simplifying this integration, and it is equals to minus U 1 upon CH minus 1 upon CC into total area of heat exchanger. Rearranging, this is minus sign, so we put as a ratio. So ln of delta T2 upon delta T1 is equals to minus U this bracket multiply by total area. Now here we put total heat exchange. Previously we put dq. Now here total heat exchange is equals to ch for total heat temperature change of hot fluid. So ch th1 minus th2, and for cold fluid cc tc2 minus tc1. So here we can replace cc value and ch value by these terms, and these terms for total heat exchanger. So we are replacing ch and cc by terms used for total heat exchanger. Here we can take out Q as a common. So ln of delta T2 upon delta T1 is equals to minus UA upon Q in bracket TH1 minus TH2 minus TC2 plus TC1. So minus minus, it become plus. Now this is, we are talking for a complete heat exchanger. Now rearrange these temperature terms. So rearrange in this manner so that we get delta T1 and delta T2. Delta T1 is a temperature difference of TH1 minus TC2. So here TH1 is there minus TC2. So we will pair this as a delta T1 and TH2 minus TC1. We will pair this as a delta T2. So replacing delta T1, delta T2. So this is our final form. If I multiply this minus sign into the bracket, so it become delta T2 minus delta T1. Now regular form of Newton's law of cooling, Q is equals to HA delta T, but here UA delta T, but delta T is a logarithmic. So UA LMTD. So in LMTD, many times it is written as delta T of M, that is logarithmic mean temperature. So this LMTD for counterflow heat exchanger, delta T2 minus delta T1 upon ln of delta T2 upon delta T1. Same notations, same formula as we saw in a parallel flow. But during calculation, delta T1 will be the different. For counterflow, delta T1 is TH1 minus TC2. For parallel flow, it is TH1 minus TC1. So that is the difference. Notation wise, there is no difference in LMTD formula. So in counterflow, many times it is suffix CF, that is counterflow. PF, it is parallel flow. So basically, formula remains same, only the calculation part gets changed. Now one numerical, that is the last portion of today's lecture. A counterflow double pipe heat exchanger using superheated steam is used to heat water at the rate of 10500 kg per hour. So from this sentence, we come to know that there is a steam, superheated steam, which is used as a hot fluid, and this hot fluid is used to heat water. So obviously water is a cold fluid, and rate is given. The steam enter the heat exchanger at 180 degree centigrade and leaves at 130 degree centigrade. The inlet and exit temperature of water is 30 degree centigrade and 80 degree centigrade respectively. If the overall heat transfer coefficient from steam to water is 814 watt per meter square degree centigrade. Calculate first the heat transfer area and second, what would be the area if the fluid flow were parallel. So here in statement it is said counter flow heat exchanger, and second question is, if the arrangement is changed and make it a parallel flow, then what will be the area? Okay, so we have a cold fluid, mass flow rate is given kg per hour, so convert into kg per second. Then TC1 30 degree centigrade, TC2 80 degree centigrade. Hot fluid is a steam, hot fluid entry temperature 180, hot fluid exit temperature 130, and overall heat transfer coefficient is given. So this is our given data and this is a schematic for counter flow heat exchanger. Now this is very important numerical because it is a little bit offbeat problem. So check out. First we will see heat transfer area for counter flow heat exchanger. So rate of heat transfer considering cold fluid. Why cold fluid? Because we know mass flow rate for cold fluid. Rate of heat transfer mcp delta t, correct? Mcp delta t for cold fluid, so where m is known for cold fluid, c CP. Cold fluid is a water, so CP of water, it is a standard. And delta T, so TC1 and TC2, both the temperature are known. So we can use MCP delta T for cold fluid. You can use for hot fluid also, but here we know the temperatures only. We don't know hot fluid flow rate, even though we don't know the CP of hot fluid. So we using only cold fluid. So rate of heat transfer considering cold fluid is MCP delta T. So TC2 minus TC1. CP of water, it is a standard 4.187 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. But put as joule per kg Kelvin. So mass flow rate in kg per second, CP joule per kg Kelvin, and temperature change, so 80 minus 30. So we come to know that heat transfer rate is 610611.15 watt. This much amount of heat is gained by cold fluid. So obviously this heat is received from hot fluid. So same amount is lose by hot fluid. So rate of heat transfer can be calculated as Q is equals to U surface area LMTD. Now U is given. Rate of heat transfer we already calculated because it is same. Heat loss by hot fluid is equals to heat gain by cold fluid. So it is already known. LMTD required temperatures TC2, TC1, TH1, TH2. So LMTD required four temperatures and we have the four temperature in a given data. So using a relation Q is equals to U surface area LMTD delta T2 minus delta T1 upon ln of delta T2 upon delta T1. So delta T1, as per the notation schematic, it is TH1 minus TC2. So put the values, it become 100. 180 minus 80 is 100. Delta T2 temperature, difference of hot fluid exit sides. So TH2 minus TC1. So TH2 is 130, TC1 is 30, so it become 100. Now, this why I said this is offbeat problem, because delta T1 comes 100 degrees centigrade, delta T2 is 100. If I put here 100 minus 100, this becomes 0. And 0 multiply by anything, it becomes 0. That means Q is 0. And we already know that there is some value of Q. It is exchange. So that means we can't use as it is LMTD. If we are going to use, then it becomes 0. So in this particular problem, this is an exceptional problem. In this particular problem, when such condition arises, so don't take logarithmic mean temperature difference. There is a second term, arithmetic mean temperature difference. So for this problem, we are considering LMTD is equals to arithmetic mean temperature difference. Arithmetic mean means a regular mean. So delta T1 plus delta T2 divided by 2. So it become 100. Now we will put LMTD as 100 and we solve this problem. So Q 610611.15. U value is given 814. Surface area is unknown. Multiply by LMTD, which is considered as arithmetic mean 100. So we come to know that surface area required is 7.5 meters square for cross flow arrangement. So 7.5 meters square. This is our surface area for counter flow heat exchanger. Now, if the arrangement get changed and make it a parallel, we are just changing the arrangement. We are not changing the given data. So mass flow rate, temperatures remain identical, same. We are just changing the direction of flow. Now parallel flow, hot fluid entering, losing its heat, so temperature become TH2. Cold fluid entering from the same end, gain heat, temperature rise, and leaving as TC2. Now we will see what is the difference. Rate of heat transfer can be calculated as Q U surface area LMTD. Now Q overall heat transfer surface area LMTD. Now LMTD here delta T1 for parallel flow. Delta T1 is TH1 minus here TC1. So 180 minus 30 it become 150. Delta T2 TH2 minus TC2. So 130 minus 80 it become 50. That's when delta T1 and delta T2 not same. So we can use as a LMTD formula only. So using this, we know heat transfer rate, Q value. U is given 1814 surface area, but this time surface area for parallel flow. LMTD we know delta T250, delta T1 150. So put all these values, and after calculating we come to know that surface area for parallel flow is 8.24 meter square. So for counter flow surface area is 7.5 and parallel flow surface area is 8.24. In a different manner, it may ask the length. So that times area is given, diameter is given, so we can find out the length. So length for counter flow heat exchanger for identical situation is lesser than parallel flow. Why this is? Because in parallel flow at the beginning there is a lot of temperature difference, so rate of heat transfer is more, but as it moves towards exit its rate of heat transfer decreases because temperature drop or temperature difference is reducing. But for counter flow it is almost same. It is not exactly same but almost same, so it is not decreases that much. So maximum heat transfer is possible. So we required a smaller size heat exchanger if we made counter flow arrangement. So remember, if we made counter flow arrangement, we required lesser surface area. That means it become compact, small size heat exchanger. Even though we can say it required lesser length of heat exchanger. So thank you.